the fire!
Always loved that expression, which is curious, since my lab assistant was killed in a fire.
What can you tell me about Cortexafan?
Oh, that takes me back. I remember Belly whipping up a peyote mash.
Walter!
Cortexafan was a highly experimental drug. William theorized that it might enhance certain abilities in predisposed children.
And let me guess, you experimented on people.
Oh, no, 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 not me. William, we had quite a disagreement about it.
What abilities?
It worked on perception. Carlos Castaneda, Aldous Huxley, Werner Heisenberg, all focused on one single elementary truth. Perception is the key to transformation.
Reality is both subjective and malleable. If you can dream a better world, you can make a better world.
Or perhaps travel between them.
What did you just say?
So if Nick Lane was treated with Cortexafan, he could change reality with his thoughts. He could make somebody do something just by thinking it.
No, not his thoughts. How you feel determines your view of the world.
You're saying that Cortexafan worked on feelings?
That's reductive, but it's essentially yes.
What if Nick Lane wasn't affecting people with his thoughts? What if he was affecting them with his emotions? The psychiatrist said that he was suicidal, right? They said that his moods were contagious. What if he was on the platform because he was considering killing himself?
Oh, my.
Look at the restaurant, all happy couples. It triggers his own fear of abandonment, and that woman caught his mood.
For the sake of argument, let's say that Nick's emotions are contagious. They're like a virus. Maybe he's even doing this unwittingly, but it still doesn't explain how it is that you're seeing him in your dreams.
If William had followed the usual procedures, you see, often when we experimented on children.
Okay, can we just stop right there and analyze that sentence for a second?
We would put them in pairs, like the buddy system in summer camp.
Listen to him. He's comparing human experimentation to summer camp.
This pairing kept them from becoming frightened or feeling isolated. Sometimes an intense bond could form. A bond which could be greatly amplified by a drug like Cortexafan.
All right, stop it, both of you. You're creeping me out. Olivia was never treated with Cortexafan.
Is that true, Agent Dunham?
I might have been.
What?
That's good news.
How is that good news, Walter?
This Nick Lane fellow of yours, it means I may know how to find him.